You guys remember that movie? It was a long time ago. The Secret, right? I still send out messages every morning about The Secret. But what? Yeah, how many of you saw that back then? Or no? You guys should look it up. Go to Netflix or YouTube and just watch it. It's out there. And basically, the premise of it is, you become what you think about. Right? That's really what it is. Thoughts become things. That's the whole concept, and that's how it started. But that's not nearly deep enough yet. So what's really important, now this is where we get a little weird, so stay tuned, buckle up on this one. It's the law of vibration. Because, let me go back to this one. If I knocked on this door, or I'm David and I knocked on a $3 million expired listing, have you sold a $3 million house before? Have you sold any houses before?
Yesterday.
Yesterday? How many homes have you sold?
That's
your first one. Okay, great job, right? But to a $3 million expired listing, do you have any credibility? See, inside his mind, a problem is happening. And this is what's going on. And you might have the confidence to do it. You probably do. Right? But somewhere inside, something's going on. And if I open that door and I meet you, something's going to happen. And this is the vibration part of this world. Let me ask you this to drive this point home. Can you tell when your spouse or a loved one walks into a room extremely pissed off? Can you feel it? Before they open their mouth, right? What you can feel it. Like, you don't even have to see them. You can just, you know, something walked into the room and something's going off around them. It's called energy. Right? You guys say yes, right? Okay, so that is 100% happening around your life. So if you are knocking on a door or somebody's walking into your open house or sales center that you're sitting on, and you at any level are feeling uncomfortable or not confident or incompetent or not confident, right? That vibe is in you and that is coming out of you and that is going to be received by them and that is going to repel the crap out of them and that sale is gone. Fair?
It's a customer who never returns your call.
They ghost on you. They just don't call you back. They weren't interested. They never return a text. They never return an email. They never return a phone call. You totally repelled them and pushed them off. You didn't even know you did it. Right? Because you didn't say a word. How could they know I wasn't comfortable? I didn't even say a damn word. Right? Because the vibe was there, the energy was there. So your thoughts become a frequency in your body, which actually vibrates inside your body, which creates a feeling which causes actions. Right? So everything is energy and intention. Everything is energy and intention. And it depends on what your intentions are, and the energy that surrounds that will either make or break your career and your life and your relationships. Fair enough? Okay? So let's get that down and let's go. This is one of my favorite pictures, by the way. Right? So this is the top there is your conscious mind. And that's just 10% of it. And that's the part of your mind that accepts, rejects, or originates thoughts and ideas and in there. The subconscious mind is the big part, the 90% below the surface, that's really doing all the work. The issue there is that it has to accept every single thing that you give it. It cannot reject. It has to accept everything you give it. And it cannot differentiate between fantasy and reality. Exact same thing. So what you're feeding yourself from a subconscious level, 100% will come out into the rest of your life. So let's go a little deeper into this one for a second. All right, this is you. There's your head. There's your body, right? And we're just gonna call this is your X vibrations. Stay with me, even this sounds a little bit weird, right? What's going on in your body right now, your mindset, your thoughts, your energies, your ideas, your dreams, everything that's happening in your life right now is happening. And that's creating feelings, energy going on in your body. You guys agree with that? Okay, and so what we did this morning was disrupted that, okay? So you have your X world that was just fine. And then we had this little exercise about what does your life look like 5 years from now, right? And then automatically your brain went into a weird position and it started creating something different, which almost is weird because it's almost like you acknowledge that what you have isn't right and you suck and it should be better. And where's the next level? What's wrong with my current level? Maybe it doesn't need to be better and all that stuff. These things happen on a subconscious level because you imparted an outside idea into the normalness that you were this morning before you walked in through this room. Does that make sense? Okay. So what happens when you do that is everything screws up. Your body and your brain starts to go haywire and it just creates conflict. Okay. Because you've got a Y idea into an X body, and your body doesn't really know how to handle that one. So what do you think it does? That's a foreign body thought that entered your mind. What does your body do when a foreign body comes around it?
Stresses.
Tries to reject it and get it out of your world. Why?
It's uncomfortable.
Comfort. It's not comfortable, right? That was a nice idea, but it makes me uncomfortable. Get out, right? You don't need that kitchen. Your kitchen's fine. Your stove works. That's wasteful. Why would you get rid of that? That's stupid. Why do you need that boat? Boats are stupid. There's boat clubs. Go rent one when you want to. You got a friend with a boat, go on his boat, right? Do you really need a vacation? First class? Shut up, Craig. That's stupid. That's like 10,000 bucks to fly. I would never do that. All these different thoughts come around into your brain because they are outside ideas and they're conflicting. So 100% of us, every time those thoughts come into your mindset, you say, screw it. My relationship, I don't want to be in. It sucks. I don't like that person, but it's okay. It's comfortable. Might as well make it work. It's comfortable, right? You do this in every aspect of your life, right? Business, relationship, personal, dreams, homes. Here's the problem. Guess what your buyers are doing? I don't need this house. It's nice. It's pretty. Sure would like an extra bedroom. They make bunk beds. The kids will be fine. They'll be out of here in 6 years. They won't remember it, what, right? All these things go in, and then they sign the contract. They talk to the lender. I need $175,000 down. Oh my God. What if the market crashes? What if you lose your job? Are we gonna be able to make these payments? Oh my God, does this not happen to your buyers? 100% of them. A seller, I wanna sell my house. Do I? Where am I gonna move to? What if there's nothing on the market that I like? What if my new neighbor's an asshole? What if the dog barks all the time? I don't wanna do this. Do I really need to move? I don't have to move. It's not that far of a commute. I can drive 45 minutes. All this stuff happens, and then they say, you know what? I know it's worth 350. Put it on the market at 425. I hope it doesn't sell. Okay? This is what's happening every single time you're dealing with anybody. Yourself, right? Your spouse, right? Your clients. This is the biggest problem, what's going on, especially us going to a next level. This is the biggest problem that we have. So here you are, X world, life is okay. Not great, but it's okay. I'm happy with it, I can deal with it. It's not that awesome, but it's not that bad. Deal with it. Sure would like that next thing. Let's go get it. That's really uncomfortable. Screw it, go back to being normal. Okay? Now, you guys have, how many of you thought about getting into real estate before and never followed through with it? Okay? You wanted to get your license. You might have even taken the class. You didn't go forward with it, and then you just did whatever you do, and you didn't take that next step. Right? Perfect example of what's going on here. Whether you moved, you sold your house, didn't sell your house, all those different things that are happening, everything's the same way. The only time things change and go to a next level is when we're able to push through to the next part. And what do I mean by that? You have to have this outside why influence idea so strong, so powerful, so emotional, so exciting that you're able to deal with the doubt, the fear, the anxiety, and all of the negative self-talk that comes about that's trying so hard to tell you you don't need it. And you say, screw it, I don't care. I'm going to live this way, I deserve it, it's gonna happen, my relationship should be this way, it will be this way, this is where I deserve to be living, should be driving that one, I need that car, I need that boat, I need that, this, that, and the other, I want it, I don't care, I know it's gonna be uncomfortable, it's gonna suck, it's gonna take a while to get there, but I'm gonna do it because it's worth it, and damn it, get out of my way, it's happening, right? It's the only time anything happens. And then you get so emotionally charged about this new next level that it becomes your new norm. Got it? And then guess what happens? That becomes your new way. You're in the car. You're in the new job. You got the different relationship. You've got the trips. You've checked the boxes. You've done the things that you need to go do. And now you're at this freedom of this new lifestyle. And then guess what we do next quarter? Do it again. And guess what we do the quarter after that? Do it again. And then you get to decide, nope. Happy, staying, or let's tweak here. That's what this is all about, guys. That's what truly getting to that next level is all about. Do you see how hard it is? You see why they have the 3% or the top 1% or whatever they want? Do you see why now? Because most people can't push through the pain and the doubt, the fear, the anxiety of that next level on this one. So that's why we acknowledge it and we know it, and we're gonna help us push through all that. Does that make sense? Any questions on this part at all? No? Good group.
We'll be right back.